all has this slightly sort of retro future feeling. You know what? I'm gonna say Lamina, just because I really liked Lamina. I wouldn't say there was things that I wanted to improve. I mean, I think that we definitely wanted to approach the movie differently just because it's a very different kind of movie. You know, one is just out in the world building front, you know, when 64 years in the past, we're making a period piece to the other movies. So, you know, making a different Pen M, that was like really fun and really challenging, and working with Uli was great, and shooting practically, you know, on practical locations and things. But that's honestly the big difference, was just approaching it in a different way because it's a different time period. Yeah, there was definitely more creative freedom. I think that, you know, even though I joined originally doing the second movie, there was enough creative freedom that I had. I knew we had a brand new arena to create, and we were seeing a lot more of District 12, so there was some creation there. And even the Capitol, because it was sort of this anniversary event, and you know, we were seeing different parts of the Capitol, we could kind of shift and change the Capitol and turn it into what we wanted. This one, we had even more freedom because we can completely redesign everything, and that was really exciting. I think it's because we, like, our reference point in the design of the movie, we're looking at the sort of reconstruction era of post-World War II. And a lot is like, we were looking at, you know, Austria, we were looking at Berlin in, you know, 1945, 1946, and just thinking a lot about post-war. But we also knew, because of long conversations with Suzanne Collins, that we had to make all the tech. It was like the games are rudimentary, the technology's rudimentary. So we ended up just kind of pulling from that era, that reconstructive era, for partly the architecture, the rubble in the streets, the reconstruction of buildings, but also a lot of the hair, the makeup, the wardrobe, the technology, all has this slightly sort of retro future feeling that was very, very much pulled from the 40s and the 50s. But we get to see the very beginnings of, like, the Hunger Games turned into a much bigger show than it was. And so I think we were just pulling again from that same era, and in the creation of that character, Lucky Flickerman, played by Jason Schwartzman, you know, looking at old TV talk show hosts and, you know, vaudevillian magicians and, you know, weathermen, and, you know, he pulled inspiration from, you know, a lot of different people. Suzanne's very involved. I mean, through the adaptation process. So when I started making these movies, the first thing that I do is I go, after I've read it, is I usually fly to New York and we sit in a room for like a week and we go through the book or the manuscript, and she and I create the sort of beat sheet of what we think the movie's gonna be. And then that's the thing that we give the writers. No, we got to read it first. She called us in 2019 to say that the book was almost done. And so Nina and I had to go to her agent's office in Los Angeles and sit in a room, and we had the manuscript. And I think I read it in two sittings. I think the first sitting was like 8 or 9 hours or something, and then I had to come back and finish the next day. So I read it two times there in that office, and then went and met her in New York to start working. So we started working before the book came out. I mean, that's the big trick. I mean, even with Katniss, Katniss does the same thing in the original series. So every book is tricky, because you want to try and get lots of those thoughts out through sort of characterization. You want to be able to visualize things. You want to dramatize these things. Sometimes you have to put it into dialogue and into the scenes, and that's always a tricky thing. So the trick for us was taking the character that everybody knows as the villain from the other movies and, you know, showing him early and before he's fully formed. And what we wanted to make sure that we did was that we could get the audience behind him and rooting for him and empathizing with him and understanding what he wants and what he needs and what he's afraid of. But at the same time, making sure that we're still weaving in his ambition and his greed and his need for power and the darkness, so that when he turns at the end, you believe it.
Ich bin Lucky Flickerman, allererster Moderator der Hungerspiele.
Genießen Sie die Show.
5, 4, 3, 2,
genießen Sie die Show.
Lauf!
Genießen Sie die Show.